It is not often that a business magazine will confer a man of the cloth with an award. On the surface, it appears that there is no meeting point. However, one party's interests are natural, while the other party's interests are supernatural. And the commonality, however, is humanity. And in this case, it is the diverse critical mass of African humanity. So there is now, therefore, the issue of perspective and then the issue of the division of labor. Forbes looks at the African continent in statistics and uses hard figures to assess her economic potential, while on the other hand, I review the qualitative. So through our work and various expressions, including the Experience Gospel Music event in Lagos, I seek to inspire the African to reach for great heights and to grasp a vision of possibilities for the continent. It is here that we find synergy between economic focus on one hand and ecclesiastical purpose on the other. My job is to inspire, but Forbes measures the effect of the inspiration. God has endowed Africa with an enormous volume of naturally occurring resources, so there ought to be no poverty on the African continent. Our problem, however, is, and has been for the last half millennium, the question of vision and leadership. The big challenge for Africa is misleadership and ineptitude at management science. It is no secret that we struggle with the management of our vast endowments and opportunities. However, the good news is that things are turning and times are changing, and therefore, what this award unveils is that the vocal and other exertions of a messenger of hope are not without signification, that indeed, the African dream is still alive. And I believe in the African dream. I believe in the African, and I believe in the youth of Africa, particularly because through their endeavors, a new Africa is moving out of the old. It is through the youth that newfangled economic activity ensues. Gone are the moribund ideas of yesteryears. Gone is the regimentalism of a command and control economy full of contradictions. My friends, how does Africa release human potential under the crudeness of a jackboot? Now the cry for freedom in Africa must not end with the riddance of colonialism. It should continue to echo down the corridors of time, because for the people of Africa to be free, our imagination must now become unbound. Our youth must enjoy freedom of expression, because the talent remains potentiation without being given the opportunity for expression. I want to express my gratitude to Forbes Global and the Foreign Investors Network for the conferment of the Best of Africa Most Influential Personality of the Year 2021 Award. On behalf of all the good people who make up my team, especially my wife and my family, I hereby accept the award on their behalf. Thank you all, because without your faith, without your devotion and commitment, this award would not have been possible nor even considered. It's been 25 years and time really flies. And though it has been a long journey, the beginning only seems like yesterday. Thank you. And God bless Africa. God bless Forbes Global. And God bless the Foreign Investors Network. God bless you. Thank you very much.